Okay, gonna get back into focusing, working the answer process as best possible. So we've got quite a few concepts underneath the answer, and get some practice in. So a 30-minute, 10-second game should give us enough time to consider the plans, the strategies, etc. going forward. So I'm just gonna select, going playing a casual. I'm not looking at increasing ratings and all that malarkey. So we'll just wait to see if we get a seek of some sort. So I'm conscious there the focus on the bullet and the blitz type thing, more recently the bullet now, may take us away from our focal point of practicing the answer process and maintaining a good focus there. Okay, let's just push through the center here. Okay, so we're just practicing the answer process in this game. It's a 30-minute, 10-second game. And nice and simple capture in the center, it looks like here. So we don't want to lose track of the purpose of why we're here. We're here to really see how we can develop our game. Gonna attack the pawn. We do like this sort of situation, attacking the pawn here. And he's not captured, he's captured back. So I believe they may have lost a bit of tempo. Their king is a little bit airy at the moment, so we're going to be able to grab this pawn here. So if we come here, we put a check on the king, we take the pawn off the board. Maybe it's not great shakes, but you know, it's something. It's attacking the king area. She usually checks first. For us, it's position, checks, captures, threats, supporting, blocking, and then back to the position again. So we will go with that. So we're not doing anything special. Excuse me, damn fly. So we're not doing anything special. So again, they've given up a piece here, which is I suppose they were going to lose that piece anyway, even if the queen had come here, but they would have got compensation with a check on our king. But they haven't done that, so we'll take the rook. So this is, the opponent is giving us this position, so it's not really, but it's being able to see these positions. That's the key thing for the answer process. If we hadn't seen that we can put the check on with the queen, then we would have missed out on something quite nice. Where do we go from here? Do we keep the king here or the queen, or do we take this pawn looking to snap this up? Do we bring the queen back? Do we actually take this pawn? I think I'm just gonna take the pawn. We're opposite the king. We've got space to take this pawn. I think they're going to take here. Oh, they're not going to take. Okay, so we could grab the pawn with the queen. I don't really see a problem with that. But I'm doing a lot of dancing with the queen, aren't I? Dark square bishop could come out. White square bishop could come out, but really, am I winning anything? I'm actually just going to take the pawn. Positionally, I don't think I'm too bad, although he does have a bishop and a knight actually developed in a way. But can they actually do anything? So he's pushing pawns. So instantly my brain's going, well, this pawn needs to be taken at some stage. We could put a check on the king, but the king just moves. Then it's got a discover check with the bishop, so we're doing too much dancing with the queen, I think. Oh, hold on. Maybe they don't go there, because obviously we can take the knight if the king goes back here. So I think the king's going to come here, which would then give us this bishop attacking here. King runs around here. My queen's on a dark square. Oh no, queen's protecting this pawn. Ooh, that looked quite nice. We'll see. Oh, mind you, if I move the queen and attack, I can't then take the knight, can I? Because I'm going to be on this file. I'm putting the check on anyway. Yeah, shame. The idea was... Oh! Stupid. If I'd have come here, then I would have stayed on it. And if he'd have gone back there. But he hasn't gone back there anyway, so I don't feel too bad now. I don't feel too bad at all. It's gone right in front. So the queen can actually just take the pawn here. And that's checkmate. Wow, okay. It's a good job we fought it through. Nice steady little movements with the queen. So we won the game with the queen. It's very unusual, that. Okay, so we'll go on to the next match, because obviously that wasn't... But hey, a game is a game. I don't know what the level they're playing at. This is a 1500 with a question mark, so I don't know what level they're at. So we go on to the next one. So just practicing the answer process. Position, checks, captures, threats, supporting, blocking, back to position again. So constantly looking to see if we've got a half decent position, making sure that the checks on the king are okay. You can also put checks on other pieces as well, you know, smaller pieces attacking the higher pieces. So that's up there in those terms there. It's not just about checking the king, putting checks on other pieces as well. Key spaces, key squares. Oh, it's me. Shame. It doesn't look like they're starting. I might be able to have a drink of my coffee. Right, so they didn't start. Okay. Well, you can see it on the screen, can't you? Don't need me to tell you. Let's go for another seek. So yeah, practicing the bullet and stuff like that is stuff, and blitz, it's stuff that I'm not really, you know, I don't like them, as we've said before, but I'll need to keep my hand in on the long play games just to make sure that we are working with the answer process, with all the concepts that we've practiced over the years. So wanting to maintain the long play psychology. Don't want to get sucked into this quick and dirty type bullet type blitzy type play. Okay, so I've taken a while getting some seeks. Is there some special game on? So I think I'll term this as a little mini workshop for the answer process again, just to make sure that we're focused. You have to have some type of focus. If you're not having a focus, then yeah, you can still play chess as a, you know, as a casual player, and just, you know, you're not interested in any ratings, you just like to play the game. And just for me, for people who are potentially looking at developing, this is my kind of journey through these systems. And as I've said before, 1800 is like the ceiling point that I aim for, really, and feel fairly comfortable with that. Okay, so we're off. Or not. Okay, just block this pawn from moving. What I'm going to do going forward, probably in this workshop maybe, is utilize some of the more dangerous openings that hopefully, fingers crossed, can sort of shock and surprise opponents. They're not the usual openings. I mean, I'm playing my usual openings quite frequently, really. And that's just to get a feel for them, especially practicing bullet and stuff like that. I have to have some sort of base of an opening repertoire for myself. Because you need to be acting quickly, moving quickly, and trying to get into comfortable positions. Positions that you're, you know, you feel okay in. Could push, but I'm blocking this poor little bishop here, aren't I? Attack his knight. No, push on. Push. I think I'm going to close in my bishop. I think that's my option today. Captures. Okay. So that means there's going to be, he's going to potentially trying to get his knights working around here, does it? Or her, whichever. Get the bishop out, attacking. So let's have a look at position wise. I think I don't really need to think too much about that one. So we capture his knights on our queen. Is it a good position? So position first. Can't go here, his knight's protecting. Can swing the queen through, can come here. And I think it's better probably because then I've got a bit of a track coming around here and here at some stage. Not while the knight's there, but I'm on his knight at the minute. So his bishop may come out just to develop itself. The queen's defending. Now, I'm not too sure if that queen position is the ideal position for them. Because it does allow us, our knight, to come out and start causing a little bit of havoc. But he does have the queen coming here. With a check on our bishop's protecting the pawn at the minute, which is a bit lame, but we're going to attack the piece. So we're putting a check on the queen, which is a higher piece. So like we said, it's position, checks, captures, threat, supporting, blocking. You might call this a threat, yeah, because it's threatening capturing the queen. But for me to sort of look at the levels, so position, then checks, so a check on a queen or check on a piece or check on a key, on a key piece, key squares. He's lost his queen. He's lost his queen. Damn. Okay. Doesn't mean we've won the game. They might resign now, but okay, so it's like we were just saying, managing the, let's just take. So what can we see? Straight away, I'm not creating any magic, that's why I'm taking my time with these moves so that we can all basically see the position on the board that has been created. By the opponent, not us. We haven't actually even got out of the gates here, but the opponent has given us these positions. Like in the last game, the opponent gave us those positions. So that's the type of thing we're trying to find all the time. Good positions, pieces that aren't protected. And again, the queen has caused a lot of damage. We could actually look to take his bishop off the board now. Could go for a cheeky exchange, not castle. Let's go with that. Less pieces on the board and all. So again, keeping it simple, direct moves to remove pieces from the board strategically. And okay, they've resigned. Okay, we could look at the analysis on that, but I think it's pretty straightforward, the games that we've played so far. And the queen again has caused quite a lot of devastation in these particular games, only because the opponent has actually given us those weak areas and those weak pieces. So it's really about being able to see those weaknesses at the end of the day, and that's the practice of the answer process for any of your games, or my games especially. And this is how I'm trying to develop and work going forward. There's no magic or mystery to it. Okay, so let's play for another one. Got the washing machine on again, if you hear any big whirring in the background. So we're going for 30-minute, 10-second games, and we're practicing the answer process, and basically with the key headings, as we've mentioned before, position, checks, captures, threats, supporting, blocking, and then back to position. So this is how we're selecting the particular moves that we're making, keeping it nice and simple. And as you know, the checks, captures, threats, supporting, blocking, they're part of the candidate process, how you select it. A chess move, and again, nothing I've created, this is a standard thing throughout chess. And I've just thrown in the position because I like the position, I like the position play and the sort of strategy around getting position. Okay, we're off again, so let's push through the center. Oh, I said I was going to do some unusual opening type things, okay, didn't I? Okay, maybe I'll do that later. I must remember. I must remember to, let's just bring this knight out here. We could have pushed the pawn onto the knight, yeah, but I just want to develop the pieces. So he's blocking the pawn, trying to gain some, and we want to make space for our king, so it's pretty nice and neat to, could actually bring the bishop here, attacking his weak pawn in front of his king. I think I'm going to go with that. When we say, as we know, just attacking this square here. We're not definitely not going for it, but it all depends on what the opponent plays. His knight's jumped in, so it looks like he's wanting the exchange. I'm not sure, really sure why the knight has jumped there, because he's left this pawn unprotected. This knight is protecting our pawn, but I suppose his queen is wanting to come down to support and attack this pawn. So he's got a 2-on-1 with his queen on the pawn here. Okay, and he's still going to have his knight in this position. So that could get a bit murky, couldn't it? Let's see how it looks afterwards. So we're momentarily up a pawn, the queen comes here. There is a bit of an issue on this pawn, because the bishop can take with a check on his king. In fact, that probably would be checkmate. Oh, it's not checkmate though, because his king has got space here. Okay, so as we pointed out, potentially just going here, and I think it's probably one of those situations where the position has been given to us, and we've highlighted the key areas that were weak. He's got his knight still out here, but he's got a check to deal with. It's unfortunate the queen is not on a dark square, so we can squeeze through here, but we've got a free knight anyway, so we could take the knight as well. His king is jammed in a situation. So we could take the knight, but there is a check on his king that could take place. Knight can jump here, but it's no point. So checks first. Knight up, puts a check on. King moves to here. Looks like there's a situation of sorts, doesn't there? But how do I finish this baby off? Knight comes here. I'm going to just see how it looks. I'm going to see how it looks. I might see it better when the position is in place. So it's checks first. Obviously position as well. I can't see anything wrong with the position, because we do have a bishop here, we've got a knight here, king comes here. And then I suppose we can... Oh, damn! What's wrong with everybody today? Not getting to practice stuff. Okay, so we'll move on to the next game then. Again, I'm not going to do an analysis on this particular game here. I think we must be getting a little bit lucky. Or we've got like complete newbies or something because of 1500 question marks. But telling you now, just because it says 1500 question mark does not mean that these players aren't any good. Yeah, there are some 1500 question marks. They play like grandmasters because that's, I think that is at the starting number. Okay, so gonna have to go in for another one. So it's making for a meaty workshop here. Let's go back in. But as you know, we like to go for testing games, you know, to really push the level of our knowledge, but also to share the knowledge that we've got, and hopefully, fingers crossed, maybe come another 1500. I must be a meter and greeter in this then. Okay, let's woohoo. Let me try something I don't do. Bring the knight out. Let's try something we don't do. That might get the old grey matter working. Damn fly needs to get away. Okay, so we're in unusual territory now. We don't usually play like this. We could push and block. He does have a bit of a power base here. Maybe the queen's gonna come here. Knight can block, but then this pawn pushes. Oh, it can't push down. So I'm gonna push up to the center, block it off, keep it simple. The queen's coming down somewhere, so it has come down to the far corner, but this pawn is now protected by the knight, so this type of position is like a bit late to the party in a sense, because it's usually the queen comes down early attacking this. Okay, I'm going to push on to the queen. Smaller piece attacking a higher piece, so basically it's putting a check onto the queen. So he's looking to champion the pawn here, so I'm going to go for the exchange. You normally they don't, but he has taken, so that's good because it helps us develop our knight. Normally they sit and wait, so they're pushing through the center, but not in a very big way. So this pawn is kind of weak. Ordinarily in this position the knight jumps in here attacking this pawn so that we can then go here. I believe if I go here the bishop is just going to come back, but then we can take the bishop off the board. So again, that is simple chess, nothing magical about that position. It's putting a check on a unprotected piece to improve the position on the board and put maybe a check on a higher piece and the king at the same time. Oh, he's gone for a reversal, but we can take the knight off the board, and they kind of lose tempo because then they're still going to lose the rook, which is a higher piece. So I'm going to take the knight off the board. I think they probably might have been better taking with the bishop, well, bringing the bishop back, you know, as we said here. Oh, another resignation. Man. Okay, well, you've seen the things we're doing. There's nothing magical at this moment in time, and we're not really getting to any type of end game positions at all. Must be the casual nature of the games. I'm not playing any rated things. I like the 1800. It's exactly 1800. You know. Okay, I don't want to go up any further. Well, we're still practicing chess, you know, so as we know, playing these sort of games, it still does help because we're still utilizing the concepts that we've been practicing. I'm gonna click again, let's go. So 30 minute, 10 second game, and this is where we're gonna come a cropper now, isn't it? So we're gonna meet a good level player at some point. Okay, 1588, again, you can't really go on the rate. I just want to play a decent game. Game aborted. What is going on? Dear me. Yeah, so fairly comfortable with utilising the movements that we're doing so far. We just need to, and we tried an unusual bit of opening there as well. And I think for me, if I can talk it through as best possible, these longer games really do help. You know, you're not under pressure to rush the moves out. It's got 10-second increment on it. Nice long game. So what we're going to try this time, depends what colour we're at. Oh, I might go for them Fianchetto things. I can't stand them Fianchettos. Let's go with that. Yeah. Yeah, that's the focal point. Remind me. Fianchetto. Slow opening. Let the opponent come down. See how we can progress. Okay, what we got? So it's me. I've got 1500s again. Damn. Nothing wrong with 1500s. We don't know really what their rating is, really. Let's see. Whoa, 2015 Blitz. Oh, that's the only one I've looked on, isn't it, really? 2015 Blitz. Okay, I'm going to do the Fianchetto, which we don't like doing at all. I think we know how to work it. So basically, we're really playing a 2000 level player. Look at that. Oh, 2015 with a question mark. But that's still high for a question mark. If we go here, his pawn's just going to drop down onto the knight. Could push up and block, but then it's blocking the power of the bishop. Could push here, then if he drops down, then we can take with the pawn. I think I like them apples. Okay, so then at least we can get the knight out. That's my thought process so far. So this is going to be a nice tough game then, isn't it? This is what we're wanting. So let's focus, make sure that we're trying as best to give the appropriate movements. Have a look at the potential value for each move. Okay, so he's pushed down. So it does give us a chance to get the knight out, which is what we wanted to do. This is why we pushed this pawn here. If he does take, then I suppose in a way, he's still going to have his pawn on our knight. So our knight needs to be a little bit stealthy, potentially coming here, and then at least we've got space to castle. So that's probably what's going to happen. If they do that, they're kind of losing tempo in developing the pieces, which is good for me. Or they may just leave them in the center. So as you know, this type of opening we're not a fan of because it's slow, but I want the opponent to come blasting out, but maybe not a 2015 blasting out. Oh, this is interesting. Okay, so they brought the bishop through, and because this pawn is actually coming to challenge, maybe we now can open up and block. But if we do that, he takes, we take, then his knight takes, and then he gets two pawns, doesn't he? Is there a different continuation? Let me see. If his knight takes, do you know, I don't think I like them apples. I think I like the apples of just going castling. That's what makes me feel. I think I'm going to castle. Is there anything wrong with that? Position. Look over there, takes. No. We push the pawn, he takes, we take. If his knight takes, and his knight's there and the pawn's not there anymore. If we take this pawn with the knight, if the bishop takes, the queen takes, king can't go on castle. That's too much. No, I think that's too much. Or I could just come here with the bishop attacking the knight, x-ray through to the queen. King's safety is key for me, so I'm going to castle. Ooh, this is a thinker. I like this one. 2015. That's high. But we have been 2000s in our long play game. Is it long play or rapid? I think it was rapid, actually. We've got to 2000s. Oh, no, it might have been a long play. Yeah, I think it's long play. But 1800 is where we're currently at. And we're comfortable being here. This is an interesting situation that we're in. Positionally, I genuinely don't feel too bad. But because I know the 2015, I'm just thinking, oh my gosh, what sort of back end treatment are we going to get here? Is our king going to get squished? Doesn't feel home alone. We do have all these types of options of just bringing the bishop here, being able to defend the king, really. Probably try to get this knight out, but maybe not there. Maybe to here once the bishop's got out. They're a thinker. Looks like we're in for a bit of a war, and I don't know if he's looking to come here or is he going to castle himself. Probably castling, but the 2000s sometimes. And I know, I think I must have upset some 2000 players with my comments about the traits of 2000 players, etc. But I really don't care, because this is my research of what I've seen of 2000 players. I know it's saying 1500 here, but again, just reiterate, it's got Blitz of 2015. So that's not to be sniffed at, really. So he has gone and castled. Yeah, so what I was saying was, yes, sometimes the 2000 plus players don't go and castle, and they go and overexert and overextend, and they, you know, they think that, you know, they've got all the control of the board, so they don't have to go and castle. And this one's taken a long time, just decide to go and castle. So we might be doing something right, or we might be doing something drastically wrong. I did say this, but I want maybe to do this. I wonder if I lose tempo. I'm going with the bishop first, like we said early doors, because it's got the x-ray through to the queen. He's gone. Oh, now we can move fast. I see, right. I'm going to take him off the board. Now he can move fast. Little con artists, aren't they? So we know he's coming down. This pawn's got no protection on it. Could develop the knight, attacking the pawn. He's just going to drop here. That doesn't look good. But we do have the bishop x-raying through onto this pawn. So if we moved, I suppose he can still drop. But then we've got a power base on this pawn if his bishop forgets himself. Also, we've got... need to get this knight out, you know. Maybe just bring it here. Maybe just bring it there, or bring this here. Bring this here. I do like that discovered check, but then he drops. He drops, and where do we go? We can't. Oh, hold on. If he drops. One, two, three. It's one of the knights. It's one of the knights. If he takes, if he attacks, we take. He takes. Knight attacks, pawn drops. Knight comes here, attacking both this and this. Okay, let's bring this knight up here because it looks like it's got a potential value of being here attacking these two. Looks like it, but yeah, it's whether they go for it or not. Interesting position. So if we moved, then he's definitely chopping. Then we can go here because it doesn't want to be attacked twice. And if he doesn't do anything, we can just take the pawn for free. Is he going to waste time doing this? I don't think so. I think maybe the bishop's coming to protect, to develop the piece. When they do that, maybe we can go here and they drop and then we jump here. Come on, Mr. 2000. Oh, it's gone for a small baby pawn move. Oh my days, I didn't really expect that. So we can go here because then we can, if he does take, I don't think he will do it. 2000 player is just going to drop his pawn, isn't it? Just going to drop the pawn, so we'll swing through here. It's all locked down. Ugh. It's really going for it. I don't want to overthink the thing. My calculation's going one at the minute. Yeah, look, he's just going to drop down. So, all pretty obvious stuff at the moment. It's obvious that somehow he's going to be looking to try and come here. Might bring his bishop to here, just attacking because he's got 2-on-1 here. So, I think that's his next move coming here. All obvious stuff. So we can go up or we can come down. Going up means I'm getting attacked, and if I go here then his bishop can take and he wins a pawn. So the safest option with the space that we've got is bringing the knight here. All obvious moves at the moment. I've always said when you're playing the 2000s, you can expect computer-like type play. If you're playing a normal human person, but if you're playing like a human type person, you can expect the basics of chess being played. Simple as that, because they've not got any extra pieces than me. You know, they've not got like 2 queens or, you know, 5 rooks or anything like that. They've got the same amount of pieces as me at the moment, and it's just how you place those pieces. And when you look at their games properly, it's the basics that are being utilized more efficiently. Okay, that's the normal human 2000 plus players, not the ones that use engines or whatever. The 2000 human players use the basics of chess very well, as I've mentioned in the traits of 2000 plus players. So it's a compliment. So I don't really need anybody coming challenging me, you know, who are 2000 plus players. I am not a 2000 plus player. I am just putting my opinion across as to what I've seen from my own research and my continued research playing this lovely game of chess. I'm entitled to my opinion and I will stick with it until otherwise proven in a different direction. But it's the to me, it is the simplicity of chess. When you go look at the higher level players playing, obviously some of them will come out with some very arty play, but to actually get a simple result. Yep, so I'm not sitting in awe at 2,000 plus players, as I've mentioned before. I'm in awe at the simplicity of the game. I'm like, wow, look how simple that is. And what? Interesting. So me, in my head, I'm instantly thinking, out of all the moves that they could have done, like developing a piece, developing the knight, they choose this pawn move here. So instantly I'm just I've got a question mark on that. Out of all those moves, a normal human person would develop a piece. I don't care what level they're at. This mamby pamby pawn move here, what does that mean? In a human eyes, as I look at this positionally, I'm saying to myself, that's not a human move. What does it mean? What does that mean? In any way, shape, it's supporting this pawn here. What does that mean? Okay, so we're assuming the knight bishop was coming here anyway, so we could just preempt and move the knight here anyway. So we then don't have to deal with the shenanigans of being down a tempo. I'm not sure what this pawn move was here. You can tell I'm a little bit riled at that. It doesn't look very human to me. So I'm going to bring my knight here because obviously I'm trying to circumvent the bishop coming here and attacking, and now he's moving fast with yet another non-type move. Okay, I'm not really sure what this pawn move is. What does it do? I mean, he's trying to control squares, I suppose, with the pawn. Maybe he's trying to, you know, control this square here because we're starting to get pieces looking to attack around this area. But for a 2,000 plus player in blitz type thing, you surely would be thinking, well, if I did push here, I mean, he moved there dead quick. I don't think there was much thought put in there. Push the pawn here. If he takes to open up, then we take. Then his bishop takes. But then the rook is on the queen, so that doesn't seem to make any sense. I'm actually going to push. Again, I'm trying to look for human moves, and this doesn't make any sense. I don't understand what these moves are. But just because I don't understand it doesn't mean that it's not a human move. Okay, I'm just looking at the position on the board. I'm going, I don't understand why these moves were made. So he takes. It's the same situation that we just went through. So we capture. Where's he going? I bet you I'm going to get stunned out of my socks, aren't I? I still don't really see what he's gained from that. Maybe he's a plus one or something. Is he plus one? He's plus one at the moment, yeah? But positionally, that doesn't look good. Yeah, he still doesn't look good. Now he's babysitting this pawn. I'm probably going to rue the day, obviously. It's just going to go back, isn't it? Maybe not yet. Get this queen in the game somehow. It's my go. I'm sat there thinking. Well, not thinking. I'm attack the bishop. obviously goes back. We did say just a touch here. Obviously takes. We'll see how it goes from that point on. But I don't think this position of theirs looks... I don't get it. Mainly because the rook is, you know, basically facing off the queen here. And then once we move our knight, queen's got access coming around here. So it's a little bit strange. So I'm actually going with what I've said. I just want to see what it looks like now at this point. Bishop does take. So he's lost a bit of power base there and take here. I just want to see where the magic is. Where is the magic? We have a 2-on-1. What am I missing? Am I missing something here? It's plus one, is he? But the position is not good. Like we said, the queen is eventually coming around here. His king is all airy. I don't get that. Maybe they move too fast at that point, you know, because they push this pawn down dead quick and can't put much thought in that. I suppose he is a Blitz 2015, that's why, so he's used to playing fast. This is his first long play game. Surreal. We have management of this square. We have management of this square as well, so we can still come here and look to get the queen off the board, but he is plus one at the moment, so maybe we try and improve our position a bit. Could get the bishop here, challenging this square. Can't go here because his bishop is there at the minute, so it's just sitting there doing nothing but protecting a key square. So even though they're plus one, I'm still bemused as to why they're in this kind of position. But I might get shocked out of my skull. Okay, so now he develops the knight. It looks like he's gonna start finding the juicy moves. So his check's on me. We come here with the queen, maybe preventing that, but is it really preventing? Even if he does come with a check, then we take, then his pawn is in the center. Eek. And then we're babysitting that pawn, because then his rook comes across, push the rook up, then I suppose, oh, it's on a white square, then his bishop comes and attacks the rook. I'm going to bring it here anyway and see what happens. It does give the option then of putting a check on the king. Got to be careful though, because if he moves across, then obviously the rook can come here and it'll be challenging our queen. So we've both still got plenty of time here. So now he's really slowed down. I mean, he was moving slow in the early part of the game, but then there was a flurry of moves. It's after that computer looking move that he did here, which I didn't, again, not happy seeing that little computer type thing. That wasn't a human thing. This bishop should have been out here. Not that I wanted it to be out. But now I've got my doubts about the player, so we've got space to attack their queen, if anything. Bring the rook across. We're just trying to focus on this king. I don't think there's anything meaty really. And are we chasing down the extra pawn they've got? No, trying to look for that position to squish the king. Because it's kind of home alone, but it does have pieces that can come back and defend. Well, a piece. Hmm. 2015. I wonder how many games he's played. Well, he must have played a few. Where does he go? I don't want to overthink what they potentially can do, just the obvious ones. I'm just thinking if he leaves his queen there, that's all I'm thinking. Try and own this file with the rook. But what magic has he got with his combination with his bishop?
Here we
go. I think I need some more. Pep me up coffee. So we said we wanted a bit of a tester. No matter how this ends anyway, it's a lot better than the earlier games that we played within the workshop. At least we've been able to show the answer to ourselves as best possible and query certain things because we understand the traits of players, you know, as best possible within our own research. That then, once, like we've probably mentioned in the traits episodes, once you kind of understand-ish what the players tend to do, then there's not really that much surprise, or you can then challenge the behavior types in the game, you know. So in essence, ordinarily, like I said, 2000 pluses play the basics really well, always going for that line that I had a bit of a question on. Dearie me, well, because his pawn's going to be there and then his bishop's coming round here to attack the rook if I bring my rook up. Okay, going to take. So we know that the bishop could do that. Maybe we force this down and don't bother actually charging at this pawn because he's just going to bring his rook and support anyway. We charge it down, could take his knight off the board with the bishop, double his pawns up. That's an interesting situation, isn't it? Double the pawns. If he drops, knight takes. I'm going to take the knight actually out of all of that. I'm taking the knight off the board, doubling the pawns. It's a form of trying to establish a weakness as we're going towards the end game, as far as I can see. Simple direct moves to remove pieces from the board, hopefully. So he does capture, so this gives us time to actually mobilize our pieces now. So I'm actually going to challenge the pawn. We do have the knight here, which if anything, if he does push, and then we do have our rook here. It's just that the bishop is thinking it's sly, it's going to come here, but we do have the pawn that can push onto the bishop now that the fog has cleared. Okay, so he's bringing the rook support in. I'm hoping that's too late to the party. I'm following the key areas at the minute. So I'm actually going to bring the rook up, like we said, attacking the pawn. bishop comes down, we can't. Oh no, we can't, because we'd have to bring the rook here and attack the bishop. Because if we did that, he'd take the rook off the board. But the bishop is got to be definitely coming here now. Itchy leg. But maybe they know that that's no good, you know, because if we do just bring it back, then where does it actually go? He's lost tempo, so we do actually take the pawn off. So maybe they're not going to do that. Does he attack from somewhere else? Oh, mamby pamby pawn moves again. Deary me. If we take, it's rook takes, rook takes, pawn takes, rook takes, his rook comes down, puts a check on our king, king goes up. I need to stop being arty. He's touching my pawn. Get rid of the pawn. But this pawn is more advanced. Should we not deal with that pawn? Which one do we do? Take or go with the rook? Or do we go with the rook? What's bothering me? Take. This is bishop, isn't it? But I'm not going to be in danger. I'm taking the pawn here. Keeping it simple, because this pawn can be taken at some stage. So we're going to grab. He's moving like he's slightly annoyed now. So the bishop's now getting into the game. With his, I don't know what kind of move that is. Oh, he's trying to get this pawn here, isn't he? That's probably why we should have just taken the pawn there then, because now we're giving him a bit of a power base, aren't we? Interesting times. That's why we should have just, mind you, if we just push the pawn up, we've got like knight and the rook on this pawn, so if he does take, then we can just take it. But if we push, then his rook comes across, then we take, then his rook comes down with some checks on, king comes up, round down. That might work, might it? I've forgotten what I said. Oh, if we push though, then his rook can come across and attack the pawn. And we don't have anything protecting the pawn. The rook can't come behind. I suppose we could attack his bishop. Oh, but then he takes the pawn anyway. That's no good. And plus, if we did push, his bishop just takes the pawn. That wasn't the continuation, what was it? What did I say? It was that, wasn't it? Oh, it was one of these, wasn't it? Push this pawn, numpty. Push there. Then I suppose he can come and attack this. Ah, it's not good. That's not good. I'm going to attack the bishop. I'm going to attack the bishop. Probably swings himself round here. Still wants to get this pawn on the bottom. Must be time for the kings to get into action. Get across. Get across. Protect this pawn, because this bishop's going to be a nuisance. Well, it is a nuisance. Bishop goes back, maybe. Well, that doesn't really work, does it? Yeah, because obviously then he just takes. We take. Oh, I don't know. I don't know, I think I'm liking that better. King can come up. Pawn can push onto the rook. Rook comes here. King can come up. What's the deal with this now? This guy knows something I don't know with his strange moves. Rook comes here, attacking both these pawns. He takes, we take with the knight, not the pawn. If the bishop takes, then we take with the pawn. His rook comes and attacks the pawn. Do we come down and protect? Then we've got kind of like a pawn majority-ish, is that right? Yeah, on that side. I'm going with that. That feels okay to me. It does actually take. Okay, so we said we're going to take with the knight. He must be in blitz mode now. It is 2015 blitz mode. Ooh, the rook has come into play. Our rook is defending the pawn. Can we not come here? And his rook comes down, puts a check on, and he's bouncing all over us. Oh, then he goes back up. He's got a 2-on-1, but our knight's protecting as well. I don't know if I like them apples. Don't know if I like them apples, but it looks proactive-ish, doesn't it? I'm going to bring the knight up. It's kind of protecting the pawn. I can envisage him coming down, putting a check on, but we're doubly protecting this pawn. Then he comes around the back here, but then we maybe can push this pawn up. It's a bit of fancy dancing. No, that's not good. He's going to push down onto the knight. Ugh. Oh, he's not. I'll put himself. He's going to push onto the knight anyway. So even if I push a pawn up to protect. If he pushes down, the rook is there to take it. Let's just defend. So still on here. Again, I'm not sure why this rook move was made. It's making some very unusual movements in this game. Okay, king's down. Deep thinking. Can't really move the knight because he's going to be on here. So if we move the pawn up, maybe before we think about, or just take with the rook. It's the white square bishop. Okay. He's got that potential to come here though. If we took and then his rook takes, take. Is that the lesser of two evils? Not happy with the duff moves that this player's making. I don't think they deserve to win this, but somehow it just feels a little bit odd. Maybe just pushing this, or maybe this one, because obviously that's the problem pawn, isn't it? I think this is the problem pawn. I'm going to push this pawn here. Just to try and take away the potential for him attacking here, because he's chomping at the bit to come down here, and I'm chomping at the bit to get this pawn off the board, or with this rook. There must be something in that position, surely. Some very strange moves this player's playing. I mean, 2015. We said we wanted a tester. I think we've got this, haven't we? I'll say the bishop's now defending. Or is it attacking? Wants to sit here, doesn't it? It's one of those rubbish positions there. You take here, then his rook just comes here, x-raying through. My rook doesn't have any support. Bishop doesn't have any protection on. Could bring this down. And he just hangs here, then we're chasing him a bit. Knight could attack the rook, but that's a little bit wet. There's no follow on, is there? He can just come here, or he can attack the knight. If he attacks the knight, dance it here, but then it's blocked in because it doesn't have anywhere to go. It can't go here, can't go here, so that'd be a waste of a knight move. We're trying to avoid bad knight moves. There's no point doing that because this pawn is going. Just attack the bishop. It's got no protection on while I'm thinking. Man, this is going to go to the wire, isn't it? It's going to get to his specialist area in the blitz. I think we need to avoid getting into the blitz. We'll be playing to their strength. These are the types of games that help improve your game. Whether you win, lose or draw them, these are the meaty hard grind games. But like I said, this is very strange. My king isn't even in the game. Need to get this up and up somehow. Up and up. But got to be careful because he'll be getting checks with his rook. Where's the bishop going? I think he's still wanting to defend the pawn, so he's King's coming here. Then he can go into the corner. So he could like go for a draw, because then I come back and attack the bishop and he keeps going back to the same spot. Oh, Chamali. Damn. Yeah. He's very special. Yeah, he's very special. He's finding... I mean, what is that? He's defending the bishop. Yeah, okay, he's defending the bishop. Match is just going to take this off the board. Plays like a computer. It genuinely does. Could go back again, but that's just going round in circles. Let's get a check on the king. Attack the pawn, bring the rook, pushes the pawn. Yeah, it's looking a bit tense now because of this pawn being able to be pushed down, which is not clever. Options. I don't think I like this one because it's going backwards again and it's like saying, oh, I want to draw. I'm going to bring this here. Potential check on the king, maybe a capture here if we get this off. Don't think that's going to happen though. Oh, we're plus one at the minute. We're plus one in the kind of end game ish type looking thing, but oh, the king's getting involved. This guy. Yeah, I've got question marks on this. Let's get the king up. Question marks on this game. Yeah, look at these moves he's making. These are like... okay, fair enough. I have to live with it, don't I? Let's just bring the knight here. You have to learn to play against a computer of some sort, somehow. dearie me. There may not be, so it's just... unbelievable the stuff to come out with, really. Wow. It's under pressure, so every move is going to be nailed on. Rook is coming here. It's not coming there just yet. Okay, move the king. Boom, 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 boom. Dun, 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 dun. Let's move the king. Put a check on. I think he's trying to make his way over here though, isn't he? Hey? Oh, excuse me. What sense does that make? What sense? I don't understand what sense that made. He's going for a draw. He's going for a draw, isn't he? Okay, it's Mr. 2000. I think I'm willing to go for a draw. I don't know what mystery he's got going on. Yeah, I'm willing to accept a draw. If you're watching it later on, I mean, this is basically, yeah, this is why I'm saying he's 2000, because his rapid thing is 2015. I just want to have a quick look at the old analysis on this one. We probably didn't fare too badly ourselves, actually, but, you know, I'll just have a quick shifty. Boom, 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 boom. 211, 210. Okay, there or thereabouts. Okay, fine, fair enough. But yes, that's what's very sticky. Let's have a look at what learning we can glean from it then. So it's saying we took the pawn here, so what should we have done? I mean, there's two options in there. That's what we're deliberating about. It's taking the, yeah, because the bishop came back and defended this pawn, didn't it, somehow? Yeah. All right. Okay, fair enough. And the knight coming, attacking the king. I didn't see a problem with that, personally. But it's saying that there's a better move. So I need to try and find a better move. It's not that because the rook is protecting there. Excuse me. Pushing the pawn? Pushing this pawn? Excuse me? Pushing this pawn? Where else can the rook go? Bring the rook here? Don't know why, I can't see the benefits to that. Is it a small move of some sort? Shall I make a move? Which one? Push? Ah, no, it's thinking. Doesn't like that. You can do better, it's going to say. Yeah, okay, fair enough. I'm going to look at the solution because I've utilized. I mean, could be a pawn push here, but what does that mean? View this. I didn't look at it that way. Because he can just drop his king down, can't he? That's a bit of a waste of a move, isn't it? Bring the rook up, check. And I don't know. Okay, if he brings his king down. Whoa, he's gone 3+. What's the situation? And do I see it? Got a rook check, but you can just move up, can't it? I don't know what it is. Nope, I don't know what it is. Anyway. Do it again. So it was just those three, was it? Interesting game. What's it suggesting here? I want to know now. Is it showing any suggestions? King F6, Rook D, nope. Does he take anyway? Take? That can't be right, can it? 4.2, 4.5. Well, it's going up. So if he takes 4.6, 4.7. Oh, somehow they lose out, don't they? But I can't see it yet. It's going up. Obvious move for me is going here, but then it's a little bit weak because he can just drop here, can't he? And if he drops there, this pawn can go here, but then he goes here, and then this pawn is ramping home. That can't be the one. Maybe pushing this? No. Can't bring that there, his rook just comes down. Can't put a check on. 4.6. If he comes down here, then the rook goes here.
4.4, it's gone down a little bit. It's moved. We go here. Oh, it's gone down, it's gone down. No, drastic, drastic, drastic. Attack the rook. Oh, I don't even like that. It's plus 5 point per check on. It might be a fan of that. Is it wanting to come here? Does it go there? 5.1, doesn't like that. Attack his rook, because we've got all them pawns. And then the rook goes up somewhere. Okay, something along them lines. Right. Interesting time. So yeah, that was a very lengthy game. And again, I didn't understand some of the movements that the opponent played. But we were playing the Fianchetto opening. The opening we do not like. But we wanted to try something different. And then we realized we were playing in 2015 in Blitz. I just want to just have a look at this situation here. Bishop's up. I'm gonna have a look at the, help me out here, little arrows. So he takes, develop the knight, attacking the pawn, push onto the pawn. I didn't realise what that sort of stuff was, what he was doing there. And what is this pawn move? Computer's throwing it in the options. Knight comes down. Oops. And again, this situation here didn't look too good for them. But they got a draw out of it, you know. Well, I got a draw out of it because I was the lesser rated player, really. I think if I hadn't have spotted that rating, they probably would have shot me by the player that they played, and I would have not been as guarded. So I think I'm thankful that I checked that situation. Okay, yeah, bring the rook up, that makes sense. That doesn't make sense for the computer. It did make sense for me at the time, but then I think I'm losing out positionally. It's nothing major, it's just that it gives the bishop a bit of power. Yeah, okay, I see that now, I see that. Yeah, bringing the knight up. Good move, okay, nice, nice. Protection. That same, bring the king into the game. I suppose in a way, because if you bring it here, you've got this pawn protecting you. Their own pawn is protecting you from any rook attacks. But at the moment, his rook can't get to my king. So this is why I left the king there. Because there's no potential threats on it at the moment. That was key, because my knight was being held to ransom with this potential attack here at some point. It's just waiting for my rook to come offline. And the bishop's in the game here. We attack. And it's seen tick. Whoop, did I miss that? Take the pawn, yep. So we can bring the knight back down. Get the king up. And then just block the bishop. And then attack the king. And that's showing the pawn move. Did not we push that and it said no, don't be thinking about doing that, there's something else. Okay, so we went for a bit of rook. What is that? Yeah, it's attacking the pawn, but his rook is here, isn't it? And as it's showing, this is ready to come down here. Ooh, no. I'm not happy with that. Definitely wouldn't be doing that move. I think it was okay going for, although it is showing that we are winning. Well, we did think about bringing the king up, but I don't think that looked too good. Was it at this point that we said that? What was I worried about? Is rook coming down here? No. It kind of felt like it didn't make any sense because we can't take the bishop. Is it looking to come here? But then his rook can just come here, so that's not any good. Boom. Check. He goes back again. No, I don't see that. Looks like it's giving space for the rook to come down here. But it obviously can't take any pieces. Yeah, so that'd be a bit nugatory. So we were winning, but I really didn't know how we were winning, really. Just trying to search and find something, but it's not coming to my mind. Knight can come down here, as it showed in the exercise, actually. Knight can come down here, attacking the bishop. Got like 3-on-1 there. So that might be okay, because his rook can't come to this spot. So that's probably what it is, isn't it? So we go up. It's saying the king going back again. Oh, now it's deciding to push the pawns. Bishop's hiding in the corner. He's still hiding, so if we go there, we get mashed. And then we're pushing pawns. Okay. Bring the king in a little bit early. Fair enough. Right, so I think that is the end of the workshop. It's a very long workshop. But this is the kind of stuff that we do with our chess. Playing these types of games and really analysing them, breaking down, trying to understand the traits of the players and basically just keep on trying to develop these key little small details of the movement of pieces, especially in the end game. As it's showing, we had this won, but I didn't really see it. I don't think I gave myself enough credit in terms of what the king can do and working the pieces together. Because he was owning this file, I think I've just felt, well, he's going to come round the back and then all the good work that I've done is just going to mash me up. And the key thing was, it's this pawn here. I was worried about this pawn eventually being pushed down. And it probably wouldn't have been able to do either as well. But, yeah. You get games like that, especially in over-the-board games. You get games like that where you go, oh, I don't know about this. And, you know, but I need to push myself to another further limit in these types of games. Especially, I've got enough time to do that as well. Especially in this game, I still had time to try and find the finishing position. Damn, just got to be brave. Okay, Chess Gym out.